Hello Flostu, my name is Tamara and in today's video I wanted to show you what I have been stitching recently. I think it's going to be a short video, but still I want to show you what I have been managing to stitch recently and to share it with you. So I'm going to show you my results with this Christmas shoulders from Just Nan and the next ornament which I have managed to stitch from the Letistitch company from this Christmas ornaments. And my Christmas stocking with Christmas shoulders is ready. Yes, I have stitched it and attached the beads during 1 week. It's unbelievable for myself. Why? Because I think I stitched it quickly, according to the things, to the fact how much time I have for stitching and my possibilities. So I wanted to show you how it looks like and I wanted to show what I have stitched. So I have done everything. I'll go quickly through to tell you what is what. So I basically stitched everything according to the key. I just replaced one color of beads and that's it. So what I wanted to pay attention at, so if you were speaking about the threads, so this color of threads from DMC, this is 640 642 645. You'll need quite a lot of them and you'll need them for the rest of the designs as well, as far as I understood. So be careful and take like enough. What else? In this Christmas trees, it's this Karen impressions which I showed and which was a really, really delight for me. I don't know why, but I was sure that this one is going to be a pain. I won't say where to stitch it, but it was super nice to stitch with this one. So you'll need this one to stitch this Christmas trees and this Christmas trees, and I'll stitch as well this ornament. I mean like this ornament, and you'll need in this Christmas trees as well. And there is enough left over because I don't remember how many inches, but it's a lot. Yards, sorry, not inches. It's 36 yards, if I'm not wrong. So it's a lot. It's a lot, actually, and it's very nice. I'm sure that I'm going to use for other Christmas designs as well, this one. Surprisingly, these shoulders were stitched, or were being stitched not so quickly and not so easily. Not because they are complicated, but because you stitch like 3-4 cross stitches and you have to change the thread and other thread. And what's interesting that they are mittens, they are white, they consist of 3 stitches each, but it's a Smyrna, you know. It's super interesting, this fact. As well, these drums, they are also a little bit of fuss, because it's like 3 colors of DMC. Also, there is craning here. This tassel was easy to stitch. I don't know why I had the feeling that I'm going to stitch it difficultly, but no, it went very easy. I know that there are cross stitchers who don't like the tassel being stitched. They are not doing it, not stitching it. They are making this ornament and then they are attaching a real tassel. I adore the tassels from the Just Nan stocking, so I'm not going to replace it with anything in the world. I'm just going to stitch them. I know that if not all, but many of them have them stitched in cranics, and I cannot wait stitching them like this. This one, holy leaves, they are stitched in cross stitches. A little bit of back stitch, so it's not complicated. It's just you have to take time to do it and not to make mistakes. And it seems that I had the time to stitch it. Then this poinsettia, they were advised to be done in 3 threads. I did them in 4 threads because I started doing this one in 3 and I didn't like the thickness, how it looked like. Probably depends also on the quality of your DMC. Maybe when Nan did her variant, DMC was thicker and in 3 threads it looked nicer. In my case it didn't, that's why I used 4. So in your case, just look, you start doing this one and you do a petal of this poinsettia. If you don't like it, change it. Because I had the first one, it's a pity that I didn't take a photo at least of that one in 3 threads, but I didn't like it at all, that's why I just changed it. This is a triple rice, but it's easy to be done, I remember. This part, what else? This part and this part, they're stitched with this one. So, not complicated to be done. I'll repeat 300 times myself. These white cross stitches are done with perle number 8, which is thicker, and I don't quite like how the cross stitches look with this one, but the effect of the, you know, like it makes it's amazing. That's why it worth doing as you are told in the instructions. And this one, 644, this perle number 12, this one is much thinner, and it's much easier to do, because this this one speciality stitch is made with this perle, these stitches are made, so it's easier to make with it, this one. About the beads, because I said that I changed, so there are three colors of beads. There is green hexagon beads. They are kind of petite, but they are not perfectly round. I don't know if they are seen very well. In this case, if you don't have the original embellishment pack you want to stitch, you can use, you know, the Christmas green petite beads from Mill Hill, honestly, and you'll need just 20 of them, because they go 4 in each poinsettia here, so you don't need a lot. Then there is the this burgundy, like beads, they are already bigger, they are not petite. This one, it's exactly like the one which I used in my Mary 15 design. If you really want to change it and you really are interested, you can go into my video and see, because there I showed the whole pack of these beads. Sorry for not presenting them here, I just forgot to take them and they are deep down in a box. And the change which I done, because the vast majority of the beads come in petite, and they are such rainbow beads, how they call them, and they are kind of, how they say, they give a vintage look to the work. So if you would like this vintage look and you don't mind, of course you can use them. But here is used a lot of this craning, and this craning is gold, you see. That's why I didn't want to make this work, how they say, vintage was darker with these beads, because a lot of these beads I used, I just changed them in bright golden nice beads. So they are Mill Hill petite, this number, because these beads I used a lot in this Christmas tree as like Christmas ornaments. Then they come here, you see, they come in the middle of the poinsettia, and a lot of them come here. So it's your decision till the end. I'm just telling you my experience and how I made it. And I also written the name tag. In a sec, I'll show you. Close. So as you can see, I cross stitched the name of my son, because this is going to be his stocking, and the two drums. So the tag should look like this. I hope I'll have enough space, because it looks like I'll have enough space. So basically everything is ready except this ornament, which I also said that I'm going to stitch. So I didn't take out the materials of this design, they are still in their box, but you know, like the main design, the design of the stocking is ready with its tag. These Christmas ornaments, I said that I'm going to stitch them all from all the stockings, so that I would have pin keeps, which I will use as Christmas decoration, tree decoration, you know, like, I don't know, tree decoration, other decorations. That's why I'm going to stitch this one. It's just I'm showing you already this work, I mean the stocking, because I am not promising you that I'm going to finish it like until the end of the year, let's say. So, and I'm intending to make a video with all the projects of this year of 2020, and the stocking of course is going to be included there, and I'm not sure if this ornament is going to be there or not. Yes, I know that still there is time until the end of the year, but the thing is that I won't have time for stitching already. The child, my child is going to have his last day in the nursery on the 18th, then he's going to have a 2 weeks break for Christmas, and he's going to be home all the time with me, and still when he's at the nursery I want to go for some shops to buy some secret presents. And I mean, like, of course I will go to the shops with both of them, with my husband and my child, but I want to buy something which they wouldn't see, you know, like something secret from Secret Santa. Secret Santa, who is mommy. And what else? And then it's Christmas, so, you know, like cooking, cleaning, generally speaking, like spending time with the family. That's why I'm not promising that I'll have much time or enough time to stitch. That's why I finished this one. I wanted to show you my ready work, to show you my joy of finishing it, and telling you that I will start a new Christmas tree. Christmas tree, my God. A new Christmas, a new stocking, Christmas stocking by Just Nan. Not sure that in this year, probably in the beginning of the next year, like in January, because if the second one is going to be stitched so easy, you know, it's super great. From Letistitch, I managed to stitch a second ornament, so I will remind you that the first ornament is such a Santa, you see? So the second one is such a reindeer, this cute, nice reindeer, which makes me smile every time I'm looking at it, because it's so nice. This one is so, so nice. And it was stitched quicker than the Santa, because it has fewer cross stitches and it's easy to be done, and not so many stitches in metallic thread, which drives me crazy if there are a lot. So I have like six more. There are eight per total here. I don't know, I said that I'm going to stitch just a few, like this year, and I'll leave the rest of them for the next Christmas, but maybe I'll finish them this season, because they are being stitched easier than I expected, and they look so nice. And you know, they are very good to stitch in between when you are having like a bigger project and you just want to like have a rest for a few hours, maybe for a day, and you want to take something small, not to switch again to a bigger project. So they are perfect. I'll see how the things will go on, but maybe I'm going to stitch them this winter, all of them, we'll see. But they are very nice, very cute. That's all what I wanted to show you in this video. I hope you liked the video and it was interesting for you, and see you in my next videos. Until then, bye bye.